Welcome back, children. So children, today again we will continue with our chapter 11, that is measurement and motions. Standard units of measurement. In 1670, the French astronomer and mathematician Gabriel Moton created a standard set of units of measurement called the metric system. So in 1670, French astronomer and mathematician Gabriel Moton, he created a standard set of units and it is called metric system. This system was standardized in Republican France in 1790. Adopting standard units of measurement does not solve the problem. All over the world, people may be using different set of standard units of measurement. For the sake of uniformity, scientists all over the world have accepted a common set of standard units of measurement called the International System of Units or the SI unit. Scientists of different countries adopted the SI units in 1960. So, this metric system, it is not solving any problem for people all around the world. It is only for some specific reason, some specific country only. So in 1960, scientists from all around the world, they again adopted International System of Units or the SI units. Here, scientists of different countries now adopted the SI units in 1960. So from 1960, people are using these SI units of measurement. The SI unit for length is meter, the SI unit of mass is kilogram, and the SI unit of time is second. People in different parts of the world also use other system of measurement units such as the CGS system, MKS system, and the FPS system. So here we have seen that the SI unit of length is meter, the SI unit of mass is kilogram, and the SI unit of time is second. So this SI unit, it is same in all around the world. It is same all over the world. People in different parts of the world also use other system measurement units such as CGS system. So what is the full form of CGS? It is centimeter, gram, and seconds. MKS system, meter, kilogram, and seconds. And FPS system, foot, pound, and seconds. Table 11.1 shows the unit of length, mass, and time in different unit system. Table 11.1, units of length, mass, and time in different unit systems. So this is the system, CGS system, MKS system, FPS system. Quantity, length, mass, time. Centimeter, CGS, centimeter, gram, second. MKS, meter, kilogram, seconds. FPS, foot, pound, second. Now, based on the size of the object we need to measure, we choose an appropriate unit. So based on the size of the object we measure and we use an appropriate unit, either it is CGS, MKS, or FPS. The units milliliter and centimeter are used to measure shorter lengths. So this milliliter and centimeter, it is short, so we use in shorter length, we use it for shorter length. Meter is used to measure length such as piece of cloth. So meter, it is used for measuring piece of clothes. To measure very long distances such as the distance from one place to another, the unit kilometer is used. So for very long distance, we use kilometer. So we will see next topic now. Now children, we will see measurement of length. Length is the distance of something from one end to the other. So what is measurement? It is a length. or the distance between one end to the other. It can be measured using a measuring scale, or we can say ruler, or a measuring tape. Vernier calipers and screw gauge are used to make accurate measurements. So vernier calipers and screw gauge are used to make accurate measurement. A measuring scale or ruler. Correct measurement of length. The correct method of measuring length or distance is using the standard tools with correct markings for measurement. So what is the correct method of measuring length? The correct method of measuring length or distance is by using the standard tools with correct marking for measurement. The scale in the geometry box can be used to measure the length of a pencil or book. So we have scale that we get in our geometry box that it can be used for measuring our book or our pencil. While measuring the length using scale, we should take care of the following. So here we will see some points that we should take care while we are measuring. Number one. Ensure the scale is kept straight and aligned along the length of the object. So we must be sure, we must see that the scale it is kept straight. Number two, place the scale on the object in such a way that zero of the scale is at the starting point from where the length is to be measured. So we have to put the scale in such way in such that the zero it has to be at the starting point of the object from where we can start measuring. Number three, ensure that the ends of the scale are not broken. So we also have to see that the end of the scale it should not be broken. If the edge of the scale is broken or worn out, start the measurement from any other clear marking. So if there is any broken or any worn out, then we should start the measurement from any other number, any other marking where it is clear. Later, subtract the initial reading from the final reading. So as we could not take from the zero, so we have to take any number from where it is clear, so we need to subtract it later. The initial reading, we have to subtract the initial reading from the final reading. For example, if initial reading is 3 centimeter and final reading is 9, then subtract 3 from 9. Then how much we are getting? We are getting 6. You will get the length of the object as 6 centimeter. 4. Also, ensure that your eyes are exactly above the point where the measurement is to be taken. So we also have to ensure that our eyes are exactly above the point, not on the side. It should be above the point from where the measure is to be taken. So here you see the correct method of taking a measurement. You see this one, we have to be above the measurement from where we are taking, not side to side. Measuring length using a divider. So this is divider. A divider and a scale can be used to measure the distance between two points. So this a divider and a scale, it can be used to measure the distance between two points. Keep the divider in such a way that each tip is at the point. So we have to keep the divider in such a way that it is at the point. Say A and B are shown in figure 11.5. A. So you see 2 points. These are the 2 points. Then, without disturbing the divider, place it on a scale as shown in figure 11.5b. So, without disturbing anything, this divider, we have to place it on the scale. Take the reading corresponding to the tips of the divider. So, now we have to take the reading. You see here 0.1. The difference between the reading gives the distance between the 2 points. So now children, we will try to solve some more questions and we will move on to another topic. Now let's read this. Measuring the length of the curve line. So we will see here how we will measure the curve line. Can you measure the length of a curve line using a scale? It is not possible due to directly measure the length of a curve line using a scale. So it is not possible to measure the curve line directly using a scale. A thread or a string can be used to measure the length of the curve line. So a thread or a string, it can be used to measure the length of the curve line. Take a thread and place it on the curve line. So we need to take a thread and we need to place it on the curve line. Mark the points where the curve line begins and ends on the thread. So we need to mark the points from where the curve line begins and also the end also. Stretch the thread along the length of a scale and measure the distance between the two marks on the thread. So here you see curve line is given. So curve line is given, we need to take the thread and we need to place it on the starting point and at the end point also. Now we need to move the thread in that curve line. So after doing that, we need to make the thread straight and we measure it on the scale. Here you see, first it has been making curve and now here they have made it straight. Figure 11.6, measuring length of a curve line using a thread and a scale. Now, importance of estimations. In many cases, we need accurate measurement of physical quantities. Hence, to be accurate, special devices are used. So, in some cases, we need accurate measurement, the perfect measurement of physical quantities. Hence, special devices are used. For example, to measure fractions of time, we use stopwatch that can show time in milliseconds. So, we use stopwatch that can show us time in milliseconds. To measure mass of finite object, we use physical weighing. So, to measure the mass, we use a weighing, physical weighing. However, in some cases, accurate measurements are not required. But in some cases, accurate measurements are not required. Let's see. For example, to measure the distance of the nearest bus stop from your place, accuracy in terms of millimeter or meter is not required. So here example is given. To measure the distance of the nearest bus stop from our place, accuracy in terms of millimeters or meters. Okay, it should be either short distance, either it is milliliters or meters, is not required. And approximate value of the distance is sufficient. So approximate value of the distance is sufficient. This method of assuming the value of measurement is called estimation. So, what is estimation? It is the method of assuming the value of measurement. Estimation is useful in many situations in our life. So, here it is given that estimation is useful in many situations in our life. So, now again we will try to solve some more questions and we will end up this video.